Nichols, 5.
Nichols, 5.
Someone saw the body down below. When EMS got there, they declared the person dead at the scene. Police have arrested an 18-year-old man accused of 4 robberies in and around Austin. The first 2 happened at Market Place Austin on the Mar, one in January, the other in March. Sebastian Salto Garcia was arrested for both crimes, and another man was also taken into custody for the first robbery. On Tuesday, police say Salto Garcia and another man robbed someone at gunpoint in the parking lot of the Westlake Hills HEB and stole their Porsche. And a similar incident happened on Wednesday when they say Salto Garcia and another man robbed a woman at Barton Creek Mall and took off with her Land Rover. The Austin City Council has approved an investment in a city-owned family violence shelter, which is the first in nearly 20 years. The nonprofit SAFE will begin renting additional rooms and apartments and hotels for survivors. Eventually, the nonprofit and city will transform a hotel into a shelter. Officials said an $8 million multi-year investment will help double their current capacity. That's about 90 people right now. Travis County is hosting a mass vaccination clinic at the Expo Center this weekend. The drive-through clinic will be open today, actually, through Saturday from 9 to 5 for the first doses, then Sunday, same time for both shots. Appointments are not required. The vaccine is available for anyone 12 and up. A parent or guardian will need to consent to the shot for anyone under the age of 17 and will have to be present for the immunization. In Williamson County, Round Rock ISD will host a free vaccination or free COVID vaccine clinic next week. It's the Pfizer vaccine. It's May 25th, 26th, and 27th from 3 to 7. It'll be held at Stony Point High School in Round Rock at 1801 Tiger Trail. Clinics are for everyone ages 12 and up. But again, parent or guardian has to be present to consent for anyone under 18. To register or for more information, you can go to the district's website, roundrockisd.org. Leander ISD has updated its masking requirements. As of Monday, masks will be optional for all district outdoor activities. And starting June 1st, students and staff will have the option of wearing face coverings for all activities and work.
Fox 7 Austin weather with meteorologist Zach Shields.
The fog we had first thing this morning, long gone. Now the clouds are breaking apart. Lots of sunshine through. Not too warm at 78 degrees, but it is very, very humid. No rain close by. Closest showers are down there in the Gulf. I-35 corridor. So we're heading for the 80s today with partly sunny skies, clouding up, and then rain starting to move in tomorrow morning as we watch this tropical disturbance over the Western Gulf. Has a 40% chance of developing either into a tropical depression or a weak tropical storm before making landfall in the middle of Texas coast in the next 24 hours, meaning scattered shower storms making a comeback in that weekend forecast. Check it out in just a few moments.